What's going on, security ninjas? Samuel here, and I like to hack things. Today, we're going to break down mid-level cybersecurity certs on the blue side of the house. Oh, and in this video, I'll be giving away one of my favorite books, so stick around to the end of the video to find out how to enter the giveaway for this book. Originally, I was going to break it down into three separate videos focusing on entry-level, mid-level, and experience-level certs. With that said, I felt it would be a little more beneficial to break down and dive deeper into the mid-level certifications. Therefore, I've decided to break it down into three categories: defensive, offensive, and risk and compliance. Doing it this way will allow me to focus on specific security roles and what certifications actually are applicable to those specific jobs. All right, for the sake of simplicity, I'm only going to cover four different paths on the blue side. I mean, there's tons of different paths and jobs you can take on the blue side, but we don't have time for that. So here are the four paths that I'll be matching certifications to: SOC Analyst, Incident Responder, Security Engineer, and Threat Hunter. First up is the SOC or Security Analyst. The responsibilities of a Tier 1 SOC Analyst typically include analyzing events or alerts to determine the severity level, performing basic analysis on initial data acquired from a security device, generate tickets for Tier 2 support. Basically, you're the first one to get eyes on a potentially malicious event. Some of the skills that a SOC Analyst may need to have include an understanding of network protocols, aka be able to read through a PCAP and analyze the data within it, the ability to utilize a SIEM or various security devices to aid in analysis. And depending on where you work, you may actually need to have an understanding of various programming languages. For example, if your main focus is web-based traffic, you might need to understand some JavaScript, some PHP, maybe even some HTML, as low level as that is. We could dive real deep into what a SOC analyst may actually need to know, but that can be specific to a job. And honestly, there could be a billion things that an employer may want you to know. So what certs line up with Tier 1 or Tier 2 SOC work? First off, I would suggest taking a look at GCIA. The GIAC Certified Intrusion Analyst and the Security 503 training provided by SANS. You'll learn various things in this course, such as traffic analysis, application protocol analysis, network monitoring, and some form of network forensics. The second cert and training also comes from the GIAC and SANS combo, the GIAC Certified Detection Analyst, and the Security 555 training provided by SANS. What you'll learn with this course is SIEM concepts and best practices, service profiling with SIEMs, advanced endpoint analytics, baselining and user behavior monitoring, tactical SIEM detection, and postmortem analysis. There's two last certs that I actually want to mention but won't dive too deep into. The first one is the CYSA Plus, or the Cybersecurity Analyst Plus from CompTIA. I know you're probably thinking, really? A CompTIA cert for a mid-level certification in cybersecurity? Yes, I actually felt like the CYSA Plus covered a decent range of topics, and depending on where you work, those may come in handy. It's a great baselining cert that you can look into after Security Plus, maybe after you've been on the job for a year or two, etc. Now, if you didn't think I was crazy suggesting a CompTIA cert, the CYSA Plus, you're probably going to think I'm pretty crazy right now. The final one I suggest taking a look at comes from eLearnSecurity, and it's their Junior Penetration Testing certification. Now, hold on one second before you click that pause button. I believe that as a defender, you should have a basic understanding of how attacks actually work. So by taking a pen testing course, that'll get you really hands-on knowledge on how these attacks affect the target environment. And in this case, if you're a SOC analyst, you're analyzing a target environment or traffic flowing through a target environment. So if you can recognize what attacks look like, you're going to be a really good analyst. The next role I want to discuss is the role of the incident responder. Once a potentially malicious event occurs on a network or in an environment, the incident responder is probably going to be the one taking over the investigation and working it until it's resolved. Depending on the organization that the incident responder works for, they may be required to conduct full-scope forensic investigations on the endpoints and attempting to triage and contain the potentially malicious event. So what skills does an incident responder typically have or should have? First up, the ability to follow investigative methodologies. Have a decent understanding of operating system fundamentals. This can vary depending on the environment you work in. I could probably list out 20 plus skills required or that you should have as an incident responder, but basically you just need to be able to think analytically and put pieces of the puzzle together. So what certifications can help you increase those incident responder skills? The first one I would suggest is the GCFA from GIAC, so the GIAC Certified Forensic Analyst. And of course, the Forensics 508 training from SANS, which is unbelievable. This training and certification will help you have an understanding of advanced incident response and threat hunting, memory forensics in incident response and threat hunting, intrusion forensics, timeline analysis, which is really key, incident response and hunting across the enterprise, advanced adversary and anti-forensics detection. I can say firsthand that I've seen the results of this training and certification. I've seen incident responders take this training and go from a decent incident responder, pretty good, to an amazing one. That is, of course, you get to actually utilize the skills you obtain from this training. The next certification that I suggest you look at comes from eLearnSecurity, and that's their Certified Digital Forensics Professional Certification. This certification and training covers file and disk analysis, Windows forensics, network forensics, log analysis, in-depth knowledge of file systems and tools. I'll mention two more real quick, the GCIH or GIAC Certified Incident Handler. I didn't mention this one at first because it's not as, it doesn't dive as deep as the GCFA does, but I can say firsthand, as I actually have that certification, the GCIH, that it does a great job of walking you through the typical incident response steps from initial to containment and triage, etc. The last one I want to mention is another GIAC certification, the GIAC Certified Forensic Examiner. Now, the SANS training focuses primarily on Windows-based environments, which we all know that most corporations are probably running some form of Windows. The third role is the role of security engineer. As a security engineer, you may be developing security plans and policies, designing and implementing protections, testing for vulnerabilities, monitoring SIEM events, and tuning detections. Of course, like with most roles in security, it will depend on the organization that you work for and what your job responsibilities are. As a security engineer, some of the skills you might need are having experience with AV or EDR solutions, IPS, IDS, firewalls, various security devices, etc. And of course, SIEMs. Experience designing and securing networks, applications, and systems. And depending on the environment, it can't hurt to have some system administration background. And of course, security engineers may have a wide range of experience and be required to perform a wide range of duties. So what certifications complement the skills that you might need as a security engineer? For a general baseline, I would suggest looking into the ENDP. That's the eLearnSecurity Network Defense Professional. It covers a wide range of topics such as access control, vulnerability management, VPN, endpoint hardening, Windows security, patch management, secure network design, advanced reporting skills, and remediation. Now, combining those with the hands-on practice and certification attempt that comes along with this, you'll have a decent baseline. The second certification I would like to mention is the GIAC Certified Detection Analyst, and of course the SANS training, Security 555, that goes along with that. That's an amazing course, and I feel that will really set you up quite nicely for potential security engineer roles as you move forward in your career. Also, one of the various Cisco certs might actually come in handy, such as CCNA Security. And of course, depending on the environment you work in and the organization, looking into vendor-specific certs, such as like Palo Alto, etc., can be very beneficial for your role at that company or even for your career later on down the road. The final role that I wanted to cover is the role of threat hunting. Threat hunters use automated and manual methods to detect events or potentially malicious activity that may have evaded your security devices. Threat hunters typically have a unique skill set. According to SANS, they should have a skill set that lies in between that of a forensic analyst and one who understands and has knowledge of current exploit trends. The first cert is one that we've already mentioned, and that's the GIAC Certified Forensic Analyst. I'll put the picture up on the screen for you here, but just a quick word about that one is that cert and the training it provides is amazing. If you're allowed to implement those techniques and tactics, you'll be an effective threat hunter and an asset to your organization. The second certification that I would like to mention also comes from eLearnSecurity, and that's their Certified Threat Hunting Professional. This certification and training covers network packet and traffic analysis, data enrichment with threat intelligence, data correlation, in-depth knowledge of tools such as Wireshark, IOC Editor, and Redline, IOC-based threat hunting, memory analysis and memory forensics, Windows and Linux event analysis, log analysis, and detection of any stage of the cyber kill chain. The training provided by eLearnSecurity is great, and it's very hands-on and practical and quite applicable to what you'll actually be doing. The third and final cert that I would like to mention is actually one of the holy grail certs of the pen testing world, and that is the OSCP. Now, like I mentioned earlier, I believe that as a defender, you should have a decent understanding of how attacks work, how they affect the environment that you work in, stuff like that. But if we go back to the information from SANS that a threat hunter should have a forensics background and also understand exploit methodologies, this certification combined with another one such as the GCFA could set you up quite nice and give you that real boost in skill set that you may be looking for at this point in your career. All right, security ninjas, I hope this video helps you decide on potential paths for certifications at this point in your career. Like I said before, I didn't cover every job that's on the blue side of the house, but this is a good starting point for you to start looking at potential paths to take. If you're interested in me making a video about potential paths and the different roles in security on the blue side, please let me know in the comments section below. That one may not be specifically focused on certifications. Maybe it'll just be focused on skills and ways you can practice these skill sets. So let me know down below. Now it's time for the Blue Team Field Manual Giveaway. There's three things that you need to do to enter the giveaway. They're quite simple, don't worry, it's not some strenuous process. The first thing is you must be in the US or have a US address because sending books overseas is quite a pain. So sorry for you guys, if it was a digital copy, it would be a little easier, but in this case, it's a physical copy. So US-based addresses only. The second thing required is in the comment section below, I'll need you to enter hashtag blue team giveaway. The third and final thing you'll need to do is send me an email to the email shown here on the screen with your YouTube username as the subject. I'll post the closeout date for this particular giveaway in the description below. I also wanted to mention that I have a really cool giveaway lined up for the offensive certs or the mid-level certs that are focused on pen testing, red team, etc. So keep an eye out for when that video drops and you'll get a chance to enter that giveaway as well. If you guys are liking the giveaways, please let me know in the comment section below. Of course, my goal is to eventually give away training, certification attempts, etc. If you didn't catch the other video that I uploaded about entry-level cybersecurity certs, don't worry, I'll link it here on the screen. You could check that out and then come back to this video to help determine your path. With that said, if you'd like to see more cybersecurity and hacking how-to videos, please consider subscribing and checking out my other videos. I'll link another one here on the screen for you. And as always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.